Swimming is overall a great form of exercise. But for those with scoliosis, does swimming make scoliosis worse? Should those with scoliosis even do swimming? The answer may surprise you. Keep watching. In today's video, I'm going to give you a brief overview of scoliosis and also share with you what the research says about scoliosis and swimming. Hi there, I'm Dr. Walter Salubro, chiropractor in Vaughan, right here at Back to Health Chiropractic Center, the place where chronic pain sufferers come for corrective chiropractic methods that help to alleviate pain, reduce inflammation, increase mobility, and increase overall quality of life without using drugs, injections, or surgery. Scoliosis is defined as a lateral bending or a sideways bending of the spine of 10 degrees or more with rotation of the spinal vertebra. Due to this rotation, scoliosis is actually considered to be a three-dimensional deformity of the spine. There is also a three-dimensional deformity with the posture that is seen in scoliosis, which is often detected in a rotation of the rib cage or a tilting of the shoulders. There are many types of scoliosis, and I discuss them all in this video right up here. Check out this card up here. The most common type of scoliosis is called idiopathic scoliosis, which occurs 80% of the time. The highest risk of progression in scoliosis is in kids, adolescents, and in teens who have yet to reach skeletal maturity. It is always best to have your child or teenager get screened for scoliosis. The key to preventing progression in scoliosis and the key to getting the right treatment at the right time is early detection. And that's what an early screening can do. When scoliosis is detected early, the most appropriate care can be prescribed with the goal of preventing surgery and increasing the overall quality of life. But what about swimming and scoliosis? Does swimming make scoliosis worse? Before I answer this question, I want to review with you some research studies, break them down, and then give you my impression. I will review with you three studies that looked at swimming, spinal deformities, and the incidence of scoliosis in swimmers. The first study I want to review with you is by Zaina et al., published in the Journal of Pediatrics in 2015. Zaina et al. Did a cross-sectional study, and they looked at 112 adolescent competitive swimmers, and they compared them to 217 students of the same age. These adolescent competitive swimmers trained at least 4 times and sometimes up to 7 times a week for an average of 2 to 2.5 hours per training session. They collected data with a low back questionnaire. They measured trunk rotation with a bundle scoliometer to screen for scoliosis, and also measured the plumb line distances for kyphosis and lordosis. And this is what the authors found. Swimming was associated with an increased risk of trunk asymmetries. Swimming also increased hyperkyphosis. That's the slouching posture. Swimming increased hyperlordosis, which means more arching of the lower back. Of note, the authors also found that swimming increased the risk of low back pain in females. Zaina et al., the authors of the study, concluded, and I quote, "Although swimming has been considered a complete sport and treatment option for scoliosis, our data contradict that approach," end quote. In essence, the study concluded that those adolescents that swim regularly are more likely to have scoliosis. The second study is by Becker, published in 1986 in the Clinics and Sports Medicine Journal. Becker evaluated 336 adolescent swimmers, 193 women and 173 men. The author concluded that 6.9% of competitive swimmers in each category showed signs of structural idiopathic scoliosis. And each group also showed signs of a mild functional scoliosis. Becker concluded, and I quote, "The high repetition nature of competitive swimming caused imbalances of musculature in adolescent athletes. Scoliosis as a musculoskeletal condition of the adolescent can be detected in high incidence among swimmers owing to the training phenomenon," end quote. The third study I want to share with you is by Milenkovic et al., published in Facta Universitatis Physical Education and Sports Series in 2012.
Milenkovic
and his team assessed 30 male and female elite swimmers aged 13 to 26. They assess their postural status and their anthropometric measurements. This means they checked their posture and did other body measurements as well. The result of their research showed that the scoliotic bad posture was found in all participants. The authors concluded, and I quote, "We were able to determine the existence of postural disorders of the spinal column in a greater percentage than expected," end quote. There you have it. The conclusions of these three studies are clear. There is a higher incidence of scoliosis in competitive swimmers compared to non-swimmers of the same age. In swimming, there is cyclical and repetitive body movements that can lead to imbalances in spinal musculature. And this may explain the higher incidence of scoliosis in swimmers. The body movements that's inherent in swimming may pose a risk for adolescent and teens aged 10 to 18, because this is the time the spine goes through rapid growth. So, does swimming make scoliosis worse, especially in adolescents and teens? Well, based on the nature of the body movements and repetition involved in swimming, it's possible that swimming may make scoliosis worse. Should someone with scoliosis do swimming? Although swimming is really a good form of exercise overall, based on the research I just reviewed, it might be a good idea for an adolescent or a teen with scoliosis, or anyone of any age with scoliosis, to avoid swimming. Now it's your turn. I want to hear from you. Have you been diagnosed with scoliosis? What type of care or treatment have you done? What's worked for you? What hasn't worked for you? Please tell me in the comments below. I like to hear your story, and I do my best to reply to any comments and questions as well. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up down below so I know that you liked it. And if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, go ahead, click on that red subscribe button just below, plus click on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any notifications of the videos that I put out on a weekly basis with content just like this. Thanks again for watching. See you on the next video. To learn more about how corrective chiropractic care at Back to Health Chiropractic Center can help you with your chronic pain problem, visit www.ibthcc.com. Back to Health Chiropractic Center is located at 20 Cranston Park Avenue, number 6, Vaughan, Ontario, L6A 2W2.